Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Matthew Coulson, the CEO of MP Evans Group. Matthew, very good to speak with you today.
Hello, Stephen.
So Matthew, you've just released your 2023 ESG report, which includes data also for 2022 and 2021. Also the progress made last year. Take us through some of that progress.
That's right, Stephen. So we're very pleased to be releasing our 2023 ESG report. It's a big deal for us to get this report published. We're very pleased to share it with our shareholders and with other stakeholders. We've made some big steps forward in 2023. One particular area I would highlight is our continuing journey on carbon reduction. One of the things that really makes a difference for us on carbon reduction is the fact that we've brought more and more of our production in-house. And so we now have 6 palm oil mills, and that means we're able to make our production more and more efficient from a carbon perspective.
Matthew, do you have a target for reducing your carbon emissions?
Yes, we do. And ultimately, our ambition is to get to net zero status. We've set 2050 targets for net zero, but of course, we recognise that that's still some time in the future. So we're also setting ourselves some interim targets along the way. First of all, to look at targets for reduction by 2030.
Matthew, I mean, just looking at the report itself, what's the importance of disclosing this data?
Well, we recognise that all of our stakeholders, shareholders and others are becoming increasingly interested in ESG, in sustainability, in the whole arena of ESG. And so it's important for us as a responsible producer, as a responsible Indonesian palm oil company, that we share more and more information with the world at large. And we're very happy to do so, of course. A lot of it is informed by and guided by regulatory requirements, but we're happy to go above and beyond that and share our ESG information with all of our stakeholders.
You mentioned that you've brought a lot more of the production in-house, but you still have a supply chain. So it's easy enough, I suppose, to manage your own operations. How do you ensure that your supply chain also meets those sustainable practices?
Well, you're quite right that obviously we focus first and foremost on what we do within our boundaries, if you like. But it's extremely important to think about our supply chain, and in particular, what happens with regard to the onward processing of the products that we sell, so the crude palm oil and the palm kernels that we sell. And when we do the analysis, we find that the substantial majority of carbon emissions, those what's called scope 3 carbon emissions, are the significant majority of the emissions for which we're ultimately responsible. And so we're extremely keen to work in partnership, particularly with our customers who take responsibility for the onward refining of what we sell, to work with them to understand how they're moving forward with their own carbon journeys and how we can work in partnership with them on carbon reduction.
Of course, an important part of ESG is the S, so social. Could you outline some of the community initiatives that the company is undertaking?
Yes, very much so. I mean, it's extremely important to us. We're a very large employer in Indonesia. We have around 12,000 employees. But our remit is much wider than that. We have more than that number of people who live on our estates in Indonesia. And again, our reach is much wider because, of course, we purchase crop from a significant number of independent suppliers, independent smallholders who contribute to the crop that we process. And so we have a number of initiatives. Firstly, on our own estates, we make sure that we provide very high quality estate facilities for the people who live on our estates. That starts from providing high quality housing, but then extends to making sure that we provide community facilities for the people who live on our estates. So recreational facilities, educational facilities, medical facilities, and so on. But as I say, we do then look outside of our boundaries, and we think about working with the people who supply us and working with them to ensure that they're able to deliver to their own sustainability standards they want to deliver on their own estates and on their own planted areas.
Matthew, are you satisfied with the progress you've made across all three pillars so far?
I think we've made some fantastic progress so far, but we always want to do more. And so we have lots of things that we're pushing forward on in 2024, and we're very excited about being able to share more information on that in our next ESG report, which will be due out next year.
I'm sure we'll be chatting to you a lot sooner than that. Matthew, thank you very much for the update today.
Fantastic. Thank you, Stephen.
Matthew Coulson, the CEO of MP Evans Group.